calling as any point platform. Okay. Okay, where you can do a multiple things, right? So let's say if you can go design center where you can design your API. Okay.
Right.
This is a design center.
Right.
Because I'm just giving high level overview only. So for basic understanding. Okay.
Right.
So
right.
Here you can see it, whatever API you want to design. So let's say in the design center, you can design your API as well as you can create a mule application, but usually people prefer it to create it mostly from the studio. Right. Okay. But here you can create a basic flow also, but almost everything is there, but mostly people, it's like a SaaS only. They are providing a software as a service solution.
Right. Right.
But
right.
Even you can create a project and deploy it into the, this one on cloud.
Okay. Okay.
So this is the one thing. So now what exactly I'm telling. So let's say you can create a mule application. So here, if you give a test flow, right, a test mule flow, okay, so creating a mule flow. And now if you create a, right, so here you can create a basic flow. Let's say you can drag an HTTP listener, so where you can request. So this is what exactly I want to explain it. This is a flow designer.
Okay.
Okay, so now if you can see it, right, if you can close and just let's say I'm taking it. Let's say we need a, you can see all these in Mule we are calling as a connector. So let's say pull something from Amazon S3, queue, or many things are from cloud, right?
Right.
Pull something from a connector. So this is called as a trigger who can initiate your flow only. Okay.
Right, right.
Just basic only. Let's say you are creating an HTTP connector only. So it will create a listener only. You can see the operation listener will be there. Who is going to will come. Now your target also can be an HTTP where you want to hit it. Now it will be your requester whom you want to hit it. Let's say some other web service only. So once you click on done, then it will create a basic skeleton for you. Then you need to, okay. So let's say you can give the path start of flow. Okay. So this will be your path will be there. Okay. One second. So you can see it's going to be a start of flow. Hello?
Yeah, I can see.
Okay. So you can see this is your start of a flow. So someone will hit a request slash star, let's say whatever we once we deploy it, right? Then it will go to a transform activity. It will transform the data, what you need to send to the target system, let's say slash slash. Okay. And so this is how you can design your flow only. So this is a flow designer. Okay.
Okay.
Same way if you
so,
go.
So yeah, just can you take a step back? So Mule platform contains multiple options, right? Multiple things to do. One is Mule designer where you can design your own API, right?
Correct. Yeah. So that's what we are seeing it. So first level, we are going to design center. You are seeing it. You can design your flow. Okay. Now I am going again back. Let's say you can, this will be saved. Okay. Now if you can go back again to the design center. Okay. So here you can see it. Difference like this is your Mule application, right?
Right.
Now, if you want to create an API, right? Again, you click on it. Now you can create an API. Okay, you can give it, let's say, a test API, for example. Test API. Now, let's say you are giving this one. Now, you need to select the version. Always compatible is RAML. So I will give you a URL where you need to learn RAML also. Okay.
Okay.
So RAML is there. So right now in market, right now there are three languages there. One is RAML. Okay. Another is Swagger that we are calling as an open API, OAS we are calling.
Right, right, right.
So one is RAML, then another is OS, and then is one is API blueprint is there. That API is there. Okay. So these are like the way, like the some like a data modeling language, how you can understand, you can create it. So basically this is the way you are defining how your API should look like. So previously the basic structure, previously we have a schema only, we called as XSD or schema, XML schema, which is feed the data for the XML, right?
Right,
so,
right.
So your the data should compliance to an schema only. Now instead of it, now mostly on the RAML side, right, this is your modeling language only. right? API modeling language like that. So so any you can choose it like that. But right now the platform is mostly recommended for MuleSoft is RAML only. But
right.
You can convert only.
Okay. Yeah.
So now once you create it, now create an API specification. So this will help you to create a RAML only. A basic RAML will be created. You can give. So it's like, just I will give you the flavor of it. So for example, if you click enter, you can put it. Let's say you want to give a version name V1.
Okay.
Then you will click enter. You want to put something description. What does this mean? So this API is for testing API. Mm-hmm. This is my first API. Right?
Okay.
So this is how you can like interactive, right? User interactive, and person can create whatever they want to create or whatever they need to define. So you start defining your data structure, right? So
So
that's what. So once you learn this one, so you can understand the schema. So what exactly we need to do it now? If you click come back, right? Even though the error, it will save it, right? Whatever created.
Right.
Okay. Now you can see it, right? The let's say the basic RAML only, where you can see the module and how you need to, like the you can see the dependency and all. So this is how your RAML looks like. So you can create it. If you want to include something, you can include it. Where you can define it, right? Then you can, if you need to embed some security, you can embed it. So this is just high level, right? We are not going to that place, but
right.
And then you need to define, let's say slash flights is a resource. Under that, you will define an operation. Get is an operation, and what is the query param? So it will support it, right? Let's say if I put this is a query param that you want to require false or true. So you can see all the option. Here you need to define whether it is a number or something. You can define it and do it like that. So these are all the flexibility. You can define it what you want it, right? Like so it will explain you what you want, what is you don't want. Let's say here you can see it whether what you want it. Let's say you wanted the min length, minimum length should be of this parameter should be 10. So now you can go it put it only.
Okay.
So then your enum will be invalid. You don't put it. These are the selected parameters. So like that, you can do it whatever you want.
So yeah, what is destination here? It's a standard notation or what is that?
Which one?
Min length, I understand, required is the false or true. False is optional, right? So destination is what?
Destination is just some parameter. You give X, Y, Z. You are you want your query parameter, whatever. Like are defining your API definition that I want this query parameter. It should be like this one, whether it is required or not. So if don't provide it, by default, it will be a mandatory only if you are creating.
Okay, got it.
If you don't want, you remove it, you delete it. Now, so you will get it. What you wanted, request header or body, and the response should go like that, right? You design time only so that someone can see your API, they understand what they need to pass it only.
Right.
So this is your API, and then API will be implemented where exactly the logic will run. Let's say your API need to fetch the data from a database. So this is the definition of an API. And once you implement your API, let's say here you are implementing or some flow you are creating it, right? That will contain your logic only, what you can define your API only. Once I will explore the AnyPoint Studio, I will explain you how to open the project or how to close it. So let's say, because otherwise it will be slow down. So let's say you right click on it and you click on open, then your project will be open only.
Right.
Okay. So it seems like you worked on Java, so you have a good understanding of. So this platform is also built over Eclipse only. So now you can see it open. Now you click on it. Now here, if you can see it, this is in, like we are calling as a configuration flow. Under that, you can create a many. So this is a configuration XML. Under that, you will have a multiple flow. So this is what I am trying to explain it, right? If you have a multiple flow will get created out of it. This is a design, and here you need to implement. Let's say you need to fetch something from a database or something, right?
Okay.
So this is a design. So now what we see it first component is a design center, how you can design your API. So mostly prefer is RAML, and I will pass it this one. So where you can learn basic thing, what is, because you need to understand what is URI parameter, what is get parameter, and this one. So this is a step thing that I will pass it right now.
Right.
You will save it somewhere right now.
Right.
So I will ping it here on the. Okay, so that is some basic tutorial I want to tell it. Maybe we will connect on.